Hi there. This is the Jim and Dee Podcast, and this is Dee Patton. And Jim's sitting right here next to me, and we're getting ready to do a show today that I'm pretty excited about. We have a couple of songs that are a blast from the past. Actually, three of the four songs. There's only one song on the roster today for our bongo fans, but that's okay. Jim can tell you all about it.
Yeah, sorry about this squeaky chair here. I'm going to have to get some WD-40 on this thing. This is a song that was recorded. I first heard it by one of my favorite early British Invasion bands called The Searchers. The Searchers were a great, great band. I really liked them. They were unfortunately not songwriters. They had a few songs that they wrote, but they weren't strong in songwriting. So in the long run, they didn't really stick around as long as some other bands. But in the early days, they were able to find a lot of great material because there was this was kind of before the singer-songwriter sort of thing. And so the people who were songwriters had people pitching their tunes, and other bands would pick them up. And that was true for a lot of bands in those days. So this song was a song that was actually written by Jackie DeShannon. Now, Jackie DeShannon came into her own not too long after this as well. And she had some great hits like What the World Needs Now and Put a Little Love in Your Heart and some of those songs. So she ended up with her own hits as time went by. But this song was one that she wrote. And one time, Searchers and Jackie DeShannon were on tour together. It was in the days when you would have a bus full of several bands and they would travel around and do these little shows where each band got out and did a few songs. And they were sitting in the bus, and Jackie DeShannon had her guitar there, and she taught them, as the story goes anyway, she taught them this guitar lead for this song and showed them the song, and they really liked it and recorded it. So we've done our version of it, which is kind of like with the, it's kind of like if you had the track from the Searchers songs and then had Jackie DeShannon singing it. So there's me doing the music on this one and Dee singing it. And so this is our version of When You Walk in the Room. That's a great tune. I really like that song, always have. And so now we have it, and we'll be sticking our version up on YouTube before long, and you can find it at our YouTube channel, which is www.youtube.com/JimandDeePatton. That's our YouTube channel if you want to listen to some more of this stuff. And so Dee wants to introduce the next song, so go ahead.
All right. This song is called Blinded by the Sun, and it's one of the songs from the very early days of our writing together. We're in Agape Force at the time. This is a song that most people in today's Christian culture won't understand because it was not written to sing in church. It was written for us to sing on the streets and fairs. And when we did sing it in churches, it was kind of to shake people up. It was a little bit edgy, maybe even a little confrontational. And
how rude.
And these days I like to say nice is the new good. Now, no matter what you do, make sure you say it softly and make sure that you don't come across as rude at all. But back then, we were kind of trying to get people's attention. We were doing a lot of stuff in the street, and people just didn't care. And so we did music, and both Christian and secular music, to draw people in to our street meetings. And as people were going by or driving by or on college campuses or wherever we were trying to get attention. And so we wrote songs that were kind of in your face sometimes.
Well, when you think about it, if you're in a theater and the building's on fire, you don't want to stand up and go, pardon me, excuse me, I hate to bother you, but you know the building's on fire. So this is us standing out in the streets yelling, fire. And so so this is it. Get ready. If you don't like loud rock and roll, put one finger in each ear, and then when we're done you can come back.
Don't know what you've been told, and I don't buy what you've been sold. I don't care what you call fun. Maybe I've been blinded by the sun.
Okay, that was Blinded by the Sun. And the next song is a couple of years later, maybe. I don't know, around the same time, at least in the same era, the same time of our life. But instead of being an in-your-face, trying to get your attention song, this song is what we would call heavy back then.
It's not musically.
Yeah, not musically. Not heavy metal or anything like that. But when we said heavy back then, it was kind of said in awe, like, heavy, man. it was packed with spiritual truth. Every verse was just a gem, in my opinion. Of course, you know, I kind of like this guy that had most to do with writing it. But it's a song that, instead of being about getting your attention, it's about kind of trying to say in our own words musically the stuff we were discovering, the stuff that we were learning at that time. And that's still a phrase that we use today, living up to all the light you have. And that's the title of this song.
Yep, this is it. Musically speaking, it was heavily influenced by the Rick Nelson material of that era. If you remember Rick Nelson's Garden Party, that was when he had gone into sort of a country rock kind of thing. It was before the Eagles. And matter of fact, one of his bass players, Randy Meisner, ended up playing with the Eagles originally, as I recall. And so it was a little bit of that country rock kind of feel to it. And I had the chords for one of his songs in my mind as I was walking around a neighborhood in New Zealand. We were in New Zealand on tour. We were staying with Mom and Dad Prattney, Winky Prattney's folks. Dee and I were staying there. And I was taking our firstborn, who was only
9 months old.
Really? Mm-hmm. Only 9 months old. I was taking her for a stroll in her stroller. I was walking with her in the stroller, and I was just kind of walking and praying. The music started going through my head, and I just started getting most of the ideas for this, and then went back and pulled out my guitar, and Dee and I finished writing it. So it's kind of a contemplative kind of thing. It's not very obvious to some people. That's fine. Jesus told all kinds of parables. Nobody knew what the heck he was talking about. So. This is a song called All the Light We Have, and it has its own meaning. You figure out what it is and then do it.
And just know this, it's the closest we ever get to country.
Okay, here we go.
Crystal sea that turned to ice. Time might just as well stand still for you tonight as you drift. Somewhere in between death and life, living. If you do what is right, living up to your light, you wake up to life. By and by and by. Don't think you have made it yet, you just begun. There is still a life to live, a race to run.
All right, so use your imagination. Imagine a, you know, a rock, kind of a rock, country rock band with a little pedal steel and lots of harmonies, and that's Living Up to All the Light We Have. And we're still doing that. She mentioned that was what we were going through at the time, but we continue to learn, we continue to grow, and if you ever stop learning and stop growing and stop conforming your life to the truth as you perceive it, you're in a heap of trouble, boy. So we're still learning things. Some things people would think are crazy, and some people would just think, oh, no, that's not for me. But it's for me. So as God shows us new things, we conform our lives to it, and that's really all that's required of us. And so we have one more song. Yeah. And and Dee's going to introduce that one. Then we'll play her recording of that one.
Well, sometimes when we write songs, they're gem ideas, and sometimes they're D ideas. And this was a little more that came out of my contemplation. I was actually, in a time, this was post Agape Force, and when our Agape Force days were over, we kind of, we went through a pretty rough time for a while. When we came home and got jobs and bought a house, and suddenly we realized that we weren't comfortable. We weren't following our calling. We kind of felt alone. And we struggled with a lot of emotions about our ministry years and where we were going from there. And it was there so much. I've heard that a lot of people who come out of full-time missions after they've been full-time on the mission field for a while have similar struggles. But one day I was praying about some of these things, praying about where we were going to go from there. And I ended up reading Hebrews 12 about the great cloud of witnesses. And really, the song is very personal to me. And I felt like everything I wrote in this song was true for me at that time. And I still think it is. This is one of the songs that we feel like God's used a lot in other people's lives. And we hope you enjoy it. It's called Don't You Give Up.
Don't you give up. Don't you give up. Angels are calling to me. Don't you give up. Don't you give up. Angels are calling to me. Don't you give up. Until the day,
don't you give up. That's our message for those of you who are going through it. And we have a lot of friends that are going through it. And we know people that are really are. And we've got to continue to learn. Again, it has to do with learning to live up to all the light we have. If the Bible says we can trust him, that he's trustworthy, then we have to learn to do that. So it's a great, great tune that we've sung for decades all over the world. And so thanks for tuning in today. That's the end of this podcast. And we'll see you next week. Bye.
Bye.